Hello. Episode 3. Last time we finished the Faerun Twilight and got back to being normal Link, as well as unlocked the hero's clothes. Now, today we'll be doing most of Faerun Woods and the Forest Temple, so maybe a bit of a longer episode. I know it's Zelda. Okay, my dumb. Oh, my capture card's got like a weird scan line coming through it. I'm gonna have to fix that later. So sorry about that now. At this point, you can buy, the second bottle from Koro here, and it's got oil in it. It also gives you a key, which is why you have to talk to him. This is one of the four bottles in the game. At this point, you should have two. And if you don't, well then, I don't even know how you got here, because you need to get the first one. Here, actually, give me a moment, I'm gonna unplug my capture card and fix the fucking scan line. Well, that didn't fix it. I don't know what will then. Anyways, so my recommendation for the Forest Temple, especially if you're on hero mode where you actually might have a bit of a hard time for equipment, is at least in bottles, is a bottle of milk and a bottle of lantern oil. You will need the lantern a fair bit in the dungeon, as well as leading up to it, so it's a good idea to use it here and during the fog area. And then, fill it up at the bird shop. Whether or not you pay for it is up to you, because you can pay as little as one and get away with it, or just go away free, but you'll be attacked. I'm also going to be showing off something a little bit unknown in the game after this monkey part. So, yeah, at this point, you just kind of want to follow the monkey. It's pretty long, and I don't know any way to skip it, so you just kind of gotta go with it. What? I didn't... Fuck this. Alright, give me a moment. Alright, that's better. There's a chest up there, but unless you push the monkey, you can't really get it at this point. You're supposed to come back after you've done this whole section. It's just got 20 rupees in it. I'm gonna get that later. That scan line is gross. So yeah, basically you just want to fight off the enemies and don't let the fog surround you, because if you step in the fog, you're fucked. This is one of my least favorite parts, honestly. Benefits of the Wii U version: you don't bonk when you slice the walls. That was a bad play by me. I thought it was in range. But since that was basically the end, I'm gonna pause it and come back to when I finished it. And we've reached the end. You didn't really miss much. So basically the monkey runs off and you grab your lantern back. There's no more oil in it. And you just go this way again. I don't know what day night is like this. Pretty funny if it labeled you as thief permanently for the rest of the game, similar to in Link's Awakening. That's a bit on the skimpy side. Cheapskate. Anyways. So now, find this wolf here. This game really likes wolves. I'll tackle you with the most ugly looking motion blur of all time. You wake up in Neverland. So you have to attack him, and then he basically just starts you with the special attacks tutorials. So basically, for the first hit and kill, you have to unlock it. Down, you'll do the finishing blow. So yeah, basically to keep unlocking these, you have to find the wind stones, which are scattered around in the game. They're too hard to find. So now you can just kind of head up into, finally, three episodes in, starting with this is what the fuck is that jump? Okay, just burn that off and you can finally head into the first dungeon. The Forest Temple. All the dungeons in this game are generally pretty long. Most taking usually about an hour. I believe this first room has a chest or two in it. Oh, I could be wrong. Yeah, there's a chest. Gyroing with the leg is painful, but it's not that bad yet. So I'll just kill some capture card, it's not very good. It's basically just like a USB dongle. And it works. This means I end up playing the entire game through OBS. So yeah, this dungeon's whole gimmick is that you have to go free all the monkeys before you can finish it. Free four in the first half, and I think six in the second half. And when you're done all that, you should... You are able to go to a boss. You also get, as per usual, pretty standard Zelda dungeon. Definitely on the easy side, but it's understandable since it's the first dungeon. Pro tip. Use this bomb, blow up this rock here. I don't know if we'll be getting all the stamps, because I remember in the last playthrough I tried getting all the stamps, and some of them were extremely difficult to find. Like, I think there's this one that was in a grotto in the middle of the big Hyrule Field section. It takes a long time to get all the stamps. Plus, I don't know the locations of them all without Googling it, so I probably won't get all the stamps. We'll get only everything else. Must be for this shutdown, anyways, so it doesn't even matter. The monkey makes you go this way, which allows you to get the chest with the dungeon map, as well as allows you to find. I don't remember. You're just supposed to go this way. So a cutscene plays out here. It's kind of weird out here. There's like stuff under the bridges that I use. That's not normal. Or maybe it isn't. I've just never seen it before. So anyway, there's your mini-boss. Or something. Not charging very well. Anyways, let's go back. Get you here. Can't really do much in here except go this way. So you just jump across here. And head into this room. This is the water room of the dungeon. So you, first off, you'll want to go back here and blow up these rocks back here with this bomb link. You just use like wild bomb juice or something, but no, it had to be quirky. And you'll find the creature. The chicken. Anyway, so Uku is back here. This is basically your dungeon warp. It's not really useful for much time in the game, but I've had to use it once or twice. So look at Link's facial expression. He's just super confused. That's great. So anyways, you want to head out here, burn this web. Careful with the snake web. And that's really about it. Don't fall in the water, but if you do fall in the water, there's a chest you can get back here. That would be a yellow ruby. Just in this little nook and cranny in the corner, you can see it pretty easily in the mini map. A stamp. I honestly thought it was a yellow rupee because I think it was that in the Wii version, but they must have changed it to a stamp. But regardless, there's a stamp back there on the HD version and a yellow rupee on the original version / versions. So you can always get that. Thank you. you'll have to go back here first, because you can cross over the second half of the dungeon early to get a small key. So you just wait for this little spinny thing to spin. Since there's only one, you're going to get across without doing it manually. And into this room over here. Which is on the other half of the gorge. You can just grab a small key from this chest. Grab that small key and then you can use it on the store. That detour is probably just there to make you think, oh yeah, I can get to the second half of the dungeon. So anyways, you come out in this more open room. Which has, not much. It has a small chest somewhere, one of the monkeys, and that's really about it. All that's here of interest. Cutscene forces you across the bridge, breaking it so you can't get back until you've saved the monkeys. Basically, when you roll into it twice in a row, you drop down into the cave. At this point, some of the Pokemon seem to have been down. Pretty simple fight, obviously. Just kill them, and you can grab this chest under the stairs if you want. Just 10 rupees. I'm gonna try and get every chest in the dungeons, at least, if not in the overworld. Since grottos are stupid, what the hell? Since the grottos are all awful in this game. Not all of them, but the grottos are pretty awful in this game. So you just jump across here to get back, and you head back into this room. At this point, you want to cross over to the other half of... the east wing. East wing of here, which is the rest of the GameCube. Swing across here. That was a huge jump. And you just swing on the other one here. You burn this web and hit you. This room's a bit more complicated than the one again. Basically, you just kill the Deku Bombas that are the, like, crazy ones. And you want to start using these bombs to kill the, whatever the hell these things on the floor are called. They're like-likes. So you gotta start using these like-likes to kill the bomb. You gotta start using the bomblings to kill the like-likes. And you have to go to the two extra rooms that connect off of here. Kill these. And you can use this bombling up here to kill the like down there. If I could actually aim my throws. Just toss it down there. Preferably without sucking. Ow, that hurt. Hold on a moment. Maybe I had to check some Discord DMs. Saying, you put the bomb down there, and the like-like eats it. That's chest in there has a piece of heart, but I'm gonna grab it later, so I don't have to go the long way around. As for now, I have to do a mini boss. This room has a large Deku Baba like hybrid, where there's only two of them in the game. One here and one in City in the Sky. It just needs a small key, so you have to kill it. You just have to attack the head and then throw a bomb in it. Preferably don't be bad. I'm gonna use one of my helpers in the middle of it because I guess one of my other helpers will work because I'm wasting one. Head has quite a lot of health, so you're just gonna have to run it. Once you kill the head, the base opens up, and it's harmless by itself. You just have to toss a bomb in it. So you can just take one of these bomb wings in the room and toss it right in. It'll unlock and spit out a small key on the floor, which you can hear kind of sparkling. You just pick this up, you have to manually do it. It's not like a ruby. And you can just take it to this lock in the back. So with that, you have three of the four monkeys in this half of the dungeon, meaning you're almost done. Just one more. This one, you want to take this bomb up here and throw it kind of like that and blow up this rock down here. This leads to this half of the dungeon. Get a little panning cutscene and it shows you where the last monkey is locked. Well, if other monkeys are small enough, they could probably just crawl through the bars, but whatever. There's a chest on this half of the room too, and you'll have to come back to this room later once you're trying to get another chest. We'll cover that later though. So you have to just open it. I think it's got the compass. No, it's got a key. So you do have to open it. Avoid these enemies, the tile worms. Come up here and grab the small chest. I think this has just got like a red rupee in it. God. Then once that's collected, you don't have to, obviously. You have to light all the torches in here with your lantern. And it will... Fuck. Fuck! New plan, don't die. Hopefully I saved that piece of heart, which is a full heal, like, right after this. I'm gonna climb up here. Careful, there's a large skeletal out here. Should be a bonus points for style put away, and you can just lots in these jail cells, so you have pretty good money in them too, so you can usually grab stuff in here. Avoid the tile worms on your way back. And you can leave the room. Come back, I'll show you later where the piece of heart is. So you just want to kind of head back to the first central room. Grab this along the way if you need to. Probably shouldn't need to if you're playing on but it's always good to have. And you can head up here. So now that you have all four monkeys, you can go do the mini boss. So this is kind of a timing thing, so I might be a bit bitchy with my capture card. There you go. Jump across there, and now here at the mini boss. Door locks behind you as per Zelda standards, and you have to fight the monkey leader. So what you want to do is you want to kill these and then find a bull that he's standing on. You want to wait until he stops with those boomerang at you and so the boomerang hits him. And do as much damage as you can to his guy behind. Pretty simple to 2-cycle him, although it's pretty expected to 3-cycle him if you don't do spin attacks like I was when you just do regular attacks. And now he's gone. Kind of a thing in this game, but the item isn't in a chest, but instead you get the item from just the boss itself that it used against you, in this case the Gale Boomerang. Pretty underwhelming, you don't use it enough throughout the game, and the wind aspect doesn't really mean much, but it's useful for bug hunting, piece of heart collecting, and in this dungeon, So you just want to blow this thing, this paddle up here a couple of times, and it will unlock the door. Three times, I guess. So out here, instead of swinging across with the monkeys again, you want to blow one of these bridges and head over here towards another gate. This gives you a good roundabout option to grab any piece of any items you missed, like pieces of heart, as well as the boss key before doing the second half of the dungeon. I'll just head down here. Across this jungle setup. I think we'll be back in this room with the like likes. Here, if you're going for completion, just head over here. Because there is something we couldn't grab earlier in here that required the boomerang. Avoid the floor worms, and instead of lighting up the torches, you'll want to put them out. All down, you can open up this chest in here. Which has the other piece of heart for the dungeon. Each dungeon in this game is two pieces of heart. That's kind of like this. So yeah, now we're done. Mostly with this part of the dungeon. While you're here, grab the compass. I said grab the compass. Chest falls and you can just open it. At this point, you want to jump across here and head into the water room again, because the water room has the boss key. If you look on the mini map, there's that little yellow dot. That's where the boss. That's where the chests are. Show the full size map. You can see where the chests are. There's one there. Touchscreen or whatever to zoom around. You can see monkey, chest, monkey, monkey, chest. Pretty simple. There's also the chest down there with the boss key and the boss itself. Super simple. So mini map, the chest appears as little yellow squares, and the monkey, I believe, just appears as little red dots. On the Wii and GameCube versions, your chests will appear as two red squares, or two yellow rectangles, not red squares. So you just want to kind of do this, and it will open the way to the boss key. Once you grab this, you should be done the first wing of the dungeon. This bridge, if it's cut down, will be permanently cut down. There's also hidden rupees around in the water. Although they're all green, so it's not really real color for them. That small key earlier. Goblins notice you. Head into this room. This room is one of the two rooms on this side area with monsters. Yeah! just quickly kill the Skulltella, and then you can use the minimap to sort of find where the monkey is. It's probably down where you want. You just use the torch when you're on it, and you'll fall right down. If you go down the one that's closer to the door, you will fall right into it, like, you can't take a bunch of damage, so that is not recommended. So just get out of here. I don't have the lantern out mostly just because I don't want to waste oil, but, you know. Yeah. Feel free to knock down these pots in here, they've probably got yellow rubies in them, which is pretty good money. So you actually have to, go up into this room. And then come back here later because it's locked. That I always forget about. And this is sort of your final, like, main room. It's where all the monkeys kind of congeal. And it's got a couple, and it's got the previous room, obviously. Just sort of your second room. Make sure you shoot down these Skulltellas and then you can climb up the vines. Nice textures. Come on, my Wii is trying its hardest. Give it some slack. Stronger type Deku Baba. One of the first real puzzles. For this puzzle, you'll want to use the boomerang on the bombling and then bring it over to the right. Doing that, you can jump across this platform and get the small key in this room. Pretty simple. I need to open this chest. Once you've done that, use the boomerang again on the bomb one, and instead, send it up and attack the entrance to the rock up there. Once you've done that, you'll want to climb up here and deal with some of these enemies. So this monkey's behind a bomb in the wall, so this time you want to just grab the bomb leg and carry it once it gets back to him and toss it into the bombable rock. Yet again, super simple. And you've saved another one of the monkeys. Only one left at this point, and you've almost done the dungeon. Game over? How is it two hearts? anyways, let's ignore that, because that was just awful. So you have to go along. Don't get hit by the spiders, so you need it. Tile worm's gone, you can now actually think. Which, I mean, you don't want to think in these dungeons, but you can head into here. So kill the spiders in this little pit. Have to kind of activate both of these at once. This game for the last monkey. There's also a chest in this room. Wow. Anyways, it's just a chest up here that has a stamp. Rescued all the monkeys, a little cinematic plays where they basically give you your way to the boss. So yeah, once they start swinging, you have to time your jump on and time your jump off, but it's not really that difficult. So wait for them, and then you jump. Simple. I say knowing full well that I would have game overed if I didn't just do that right. Should be a fairy back here. Most dungeons have a fairy right before the boss. There it is. I'm gonna bottle that. Because I have an empty bottle. It's recommended you keep a fairy in a bottle during this game, just in general. Especially if you're in hero mode. Because it might not be as efficient as milk early in the game, but it's a survival factor. It's equally useful just as farther into the game, so yeah. Although if you can get great fairies, tears or rare chew jelly, those are the best healing items. Although those are really hard to find. Great fairies, tears, you can only get like if you finish the cave war deals or one of them during the main quest. Or no, from a side quest. And rare chew jelly is, get this, rare. Yeah, man. Basically, you want to feed these things the bombs with your boomerang, and once they're both down, the boss will really win. So at this point you can't really do much except run around and dodge the attacks. Not like that. Because there's no more bombs, just to the moon. Now your monkey shows up. The monkey shows up. When they show up can be determined by the music cues because it is based off of the time after phase 2 hours. You can actually just target lock those. And you want to blow up the heads again. Not like that, that was stupid. Like before. Grab that to the head. And now you can only do the main thing. Which one's hit with a bomb? Well, open up for you to attack it. Once you get a few attacks in, you'll be behind in the last part. You want to avoid this gigantic poison spear. As well as has evidence why that very use. If you're smart, you can actually go straight for the main head sometimes. At least I thought you could. If you're in phase 2, you can do a finishing blow, which is style points. I'm gonna try and do every finishing blow. There you go. You finished the first dungeon in the game. You only game overed once, used a fairy, and didn't heal much because hero mode is too difficult in the beginning and not difficult enough later. Savinda takes a few shadow piece.
What has my beard do? You pointy power. A squealy power. Come to me, what's good for power? Be what we be. What did he?
So yeah, you just grab this heart container, which is a full heal plus one more heart. And you can head into the portal. I recommend for the second dungeon, well, actually I'll get to that later. So there you go, first dungeon finished. So yeah, basically, the spirit tells you, go west, fuck you. So yeah, I don't really have anything else to be doing, so I'm gonna just... Well, actually, I think I'll end it off here, really. So, thanks for watching.